Hi, I'm Lee Reams, and I'm back here with some more breaking news. This time we're talking about Congress has just passed reached agreement on the COVID relief package, and I'll have to go over some of the details with you today. We don't know all the information, but we got some of the more pertinent details here. So finally, the political beckoning is over. And the stimulus payments are going to be added to this agreement. And so another round is included, but this time only $600 per eligible adult. And that's down from the $1,200 we had for the prior authorized stimulus payments back in March by the CARES Act. But this time it's going to also include $600 per dependent child. So the maximum payment amounts, each eligible adult's gonna get $600. Married couple, that's for two of them, be two times 600, be $1,200. And each dependent child would be 600. So now these get phased out for higher income taxpayers. So you can see from the chart there, for unmarried taxpayers and those filing married, filing separate, the threshold for the phase out is $75,000. Heads of household, the phase-out threshold is $112,500, and for married taxpayers filing joints, $150,000. Now, the way that works, let's take an example. Let's suppose we have this married couple with two children, and their AGI is $175,000. So we subtract the threshold, and we end up with $25,000, and 5% of that's phased out, which is $1,250. So if their payment would normally be $2,400 because of their high income, they're gonna lose $1,250 of it. So their stimulus payment will only be $1,150. So that's the way the phase out works. They also extended the unemployment assistance for 16 weeks through March 14th, 2021. But this time the federal supplement will only be $300 per week. Where it is right now, $600 through the end of this month. So, but after that, it's going to drop to $300 a week, and that's through March 14th, 2021. They're also having another additional targeted loans under the Paycheck Protection Program loans. However, this time they're going to be a little more sophisticated about it, and they're going to limit it to only to small businesses. That's only if they have 300 or fewer employees and is important, 30% revenue loss in any quarter in 2020 as compared to the same quarter in 2019. And there's different types of forgiven expenses are available. And that's going to include this time around supplier costs and facility modifications, you know, like they've been doing to protect people from getting the COVID transmissions and personal protective gear so they can operate safely. And expenses, this is a biggie, expenses paid with the forgiven loan proceeds are going to be tax deductible. So remember back to the original CARES Act, and it was Congress's intent, I guess, that the loans be forgiven, but the expenses still be deductible. But the IRS took a different impression on that and just 2 weeks ago came out with a revenue ruling saying that the expenses would not be deductible if they were paid for with forgiven loan proceeds. But now Congress has come back and said, no, that's not right, and that they will be deductible even if they were paid for with forgiven loan proceeds. So we also have the Earned Income Tax Credit and Child Tax Credit. You can use the 2019 incomes to figure those for 2020 credits. And the reason for that is a lot of people have their incomes are substantially reduced, which would then substantially reduce the earned income tax credit and the child tax credit because they are based upon the earned income of individuals and their taxable income. So. Okay, so we also have a new rental assistance program that came in with this legislation, and it's $25 billion. It's the first ever they've had of a federal rental assistance program. Now, these funds are going to be distributed to state and local governments, and each state must establish a system for distributing the funds. So we won't be looking to federal for this information. It'll be coming from the state when they finally put their programs together. But the federal government will fund it. And the funds will be targeted to families impacted by COVID, those that are struggling to pay their rent or have past due rent. And the funds can be used for past due or future rent and to avoid utility shutoffs. And $800 million of that is reserved for the Native American housing. In addition, the Centers for Disease Control, CDC, has an eviction moratorium, and that's been extended through January 31st, 2021. Now, we've only included highlights of the legislation. There are other provisions that will directly or indirectly impact individuals and small businesses. And although he has said he will sign it, President Trump must sign the legislation before it becomes law. So I want to thank you for joining us, and I look forward to join us for next breaking news. Take care.